Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel, and I hope you're all doing great. And in today's video I'm going to be talking about the Brackets text editor, and we are going to be covering the installation, the themes and the plugins that the text editor has to offer. So let's get started. You can go to the Brackets website called brackets.io and download the package from there for installation. Or alternatively, you can also go to Ubuntu software and just search for Brackets. So for me, I will just install it from Ubuntu software. And there we have it installed. Now let's go ahead and launch it. So for the first time when I launch Brackets, this is how it actually looks like. I'm gonna first go ahead and start looking at the extension manager, and I'm gonna start looking at the themes that are available. So let's install some of these themes. So I have gone ahead and installed the 10 most downloaded themes. Now let's have a look at them in action. So I go to View and then go to Themes, and then I can switch my current theme from here, 808. This is how it looks like. Brackets Dark. Brackets Light is the default theme. Earth. Railcasts. Ruby Blue. Envy. Monokai. Enlightened. And tomorrow night. So let me keep it as tomorrow night. I can also increase and decrease the font size by pressing Ctrl plus and Ctrl minus. One of the really great features that I like about Brackets is the ability to have a live preview. So let me launch the live preview. And what it's doing is just launching a preview of the HTML. So let me move that on the right side and keep my preview on the left side. So I can see the preview of my website on the Chrome browser. And if I highlight any section, it will actually highlight the same on my browser. So it also does something similar to a hot reload. So if I change something here, let me add hi there. And you can see it automatically updates that section in the browser. And this is really great for web development. Let me say that I want to split my editor into a horizontal split. And let's see if I want to open another window with the CSS file. So I can work on my HTML and CSS simultaneously by having the visibility of both the documents. And I can also preview that on the web browser. So really a really good feature. Now let's go ahead and have a look at some of the extensions that I have installed in Brackets. The first one that I'm going to show is called Auto Save Every Edit. It allows you to automatically save your work So after installing the extension, you can go into File and you can check the Enable Auto Save box. So you can also configure the amount of time that elapses before it autosaves, and you can check that by going into the autosave config and configuring the same. Next up, we are going to have a look at the Brackets Git extension, and this enables Git integration into Brackets. So after installing the extension, you will see a Git icon appearing on the toolbar on the right. Once you click on the toolbar icon, you will see your details of your Git appearing over here, and you can perform the various Git operations like pull, push, commit, everything from within the IDE. And this also has this Git settings option, and you can configure this to your liking. Next up, we are going to have a look at the Brackets icons extension, and once you have it installed, you can go into your view menu and then have a look at the dev icons. So you can enable the extension by selecting the dev icons, and that's how it appears in your navigation bar. And if I go back into the view and enable the Ionic icons, that's the original set of icons. If we go into the Brackets icons extension repository in GitHub, you will be able to see that it actually supports various different kinds of files, and that's the kind of files that it's supporting. And once it's installed, you can see that it will actually show a different set of icons for all of your different file types. So next up, we are going to have a look at the SFTP upload extension. And once you have the extension installed, you will see that the SFTP upload icon will appear on the toolbar on the right hand side. And if I click on it, it will open up the SFTP upload panel. So let me close the Git panel and open the SFTP upload. So as you can see, I can upload these files, and this is really handy for a web developer. And if I go to server setup, I can actually set up my SFTP host and all my credentials in there. So moving on, next let us have a look at the emmet extension. And this extension is really powerful for HTML and CSS development. And once you have it installed, you can actually go back and run a lot of shortcuts. These shortcuts or abbreviations will allow you to generate the structure of the tags in Brackets using emmet, and you can generate a lot of HTML and CSS type structures. So let's have a look at some of the examples. So to create a skeleton HTML structure, I can just simply type exclamation mark and tab, and that will print out the whole structure. So to create child elements, I can simply type the greater than sign. So as an example, if I want to make an unordered list, I can just type UL greater than LI and then tab, and that will create that structure. Another example, I can say div greater than UL greater than LI, and that will be the structure that gets created. To create an ID, I can just use the hash text. As an example, I can say hash heading text and just tab, and that will create a div with that ID. And to create something multiple times, I can also use the star character. As an example, I can create unordered list, and then I can times it by 6. And that's how it will appear. So as you can see, emmet is a really powerful extension, and if you're working on HTML and CSS primarily, you will really love it. Next up, let's have a look at the todo extension. Once your extension is installed, you can enable the todo panel by clicking on the view button in your menu and making sure that the todo checkbox is checked. This will enable the todo panel to be visible at the bottom. Now in your source code, if you add any to-dos, they will appear in the to-do panel at the bottom. As an example, let's add a to-do over here. And once I did that, it actually makes the to-do appear over here. So with that, we conclude the today's session on Brackets Text Editor. And I hope you find this video useful, and thanks a lot for watching.